here's the top five intros to the MCU movies. For this list, I kind of want to do the first 5 minutes, or at least until you see the title card of the movie. I wanted to give some honorable mentions that didn't make it to the top five. For example, Black Panther Wakanda Forever has an amazing intro that pays great homage to Chadwick Boseman. Iron Man 2 is one of my favorite intros. It's super awesome, super cool, and plus, I like the movie. It's a guilty pleasure. But okay, to start my list, for number 5, I have Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. I have to say, the intros that James Gunn does are just amazing. Even for movies like The Suicide Squad, he did an amazing job doing that intro. This intro is great because we get to see a backstory of Peter Quill's mom and his dad, and then we get to see Groot dancing, and in the background, we get to see a great battle sequence. Yet, we're focused on Groot, and I like the way they did that. Like, we could see in the background, it's blurred out. We get to see the heroes fighting, and it's really good. I really liked how they handled that. And then we get Mr. Blue Sky playing while this is going on. Really cool. I like that intro. At number 4, I have Iron Man. This is the movie that started it all, and it has to have a great intro. And this introduction to Tony Stark was really good because we get to see the funny, the playboy, the genius that Tony Stark is put into a crazy situation that was traumatizing for him and for us, the audience, as well. It's quite traumatizing. And to think of it, like, that was the day that Tony Stark's life changed forever. Plus, you get AC/DC's back in Black. For number 3, I have the first Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 1. I remember walking into the first Guardians of the Galaxy movie, I had no idea who these characters were, and I remember we get this emotional scene between Peter's mom and Peter, and I gotta say, props to the kid, because he did a great job acting. But not only that, after that emotional scene, we get this really funny scene where Chris Pratt is dancing to Come and Get Your Love, and what a great intro scene, because a lot of people were laughing, and I wasn't expecting it to be that hilarious. That emotional, that switch of emotions was just really great, and I really liked it. Great intro, set the mood for the whole movie, and really gave us a really great start to the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 1. At number 2, I'm gonna have Avengers Infinity War.
We have a Hulk.
Let him have his fun.
Do you want to know how to make a villain intimidating? You put him up against the strongest hero in the Avengers, and you make him win. Which is, that is pretty much what the Russo brothers did, because Thanos, we didn't know how strong he was, but when we put him up against the Hulk and we saw him beat the butt out of him, great way to set the tone and great way to make a villain just so powerful. I found it very poetic how the heroes lost in the first scene of the movie and they lost in the last scene of the movie as well, which is just great storytelling. I also just watched Avengers Infinity War on Disney Plus, and if you didn't know, most of the Marvel movies are enhanced in IMAX, so watching it on the big screen was really great, and you could really tell that they did such a great job motion capturing and with the CGI on Thanos's face. It looks really good. But before I give you number 1, I just want to say I really appreciate the support from all of you guys. I'm currently right now at 300 subscribers, and I would really appreciate it if you guys would subscribe and like this video as well. I'm really enjoying making these videos, and I really appreciate the support. Thank you. And at my number 1 slot, I'm going to have Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. Minor spoilers for Volume 3. This is the first 5 minutes of the movie. But if you haven't seen the movie, go watch it, then watch this video. This is my favorite intro to any MCU movie. The intro we get is this anxiety rising scene where we see baby Rocket Raccoon being pulled by the High Evolutionary, and while that is happening, You get this rising bass sound as it's reaching out, and it's reaching out towards us, the audience, in the theater. It felt very surreal. It felt very scary, especially when there was a huge hand reaching out to you. And then not only that, the way the music transitions, it immediately cuts into Creep, which is one of my favorite songs of all time by Radiohead. And this acoustic cover of Creep just really set the tone again for the whole movie. And I remember as I was watching it, I thought to myself, oh my god, this is it for Rocket Raccoon. We're not going to see anything more of him. And then it's a great intro to the Guardians. You know, you see Nebula, you see Drax, we see Cosmo, Mantis, and even Peter at the end. But you can totally get a sense that Rocket, at the end of this, something major is going to happen to him. And then after this, we get this amazing superhero walk with them carrying Peter Quill at the end. It was just really good. An amazing intro. I loved it. And it gave me back hope for the MCU, because these past movies haven't been that too great. So it was just good to see an amazing intro. And I love that for James Gunn. Super happy you're Team DC, by the way. I'm so excited to see what you're gonna do. What is your favorite intro to the any MCU movie of all time? Please let me know down below if you agree with me or not. That's totally fine. Just let me know down below. And as always, thank you guys for watching, and God bless.